So Larry Hogan will be sworn in today for his second term in office as governor of Maryland, the first time since the 1950s that a Republican will serve back-to-back terms in Maryland as governor. Really is astonishing when you think about it. Larry Hogan is a political unicorn. There's no other way to say it. I mean, he's a moderate Republican with tremendous success in the world of Donald Trump, where Donald Trump has taken over the Republican Party. Now, look, in another part of this country, Larry Hogan would be considered a Democrat, if we're honest. I mean, he would. I mean, there are those on the hard right who would call him a rhino, right? He is not in any way a Trump Republican, any kind of stretch of the imagination. He's just not, and he distanced himself from Donald Trump on a regular basis. His political soul brother, I would say, would be who? John Kasich of Ohio, right? Who, you know, most Republicans today don't like at all. I mean, they see him as squishy, as a moderate, which is a dirty word in many parts of the Republican Party, or establishment, swampy, right? I mean, John Kasich got just destroyed. He got beat worse than the Orioles did last year to Donald Trump when he ran for president of the United States. Yet, Larry Hogan is extremely popular. He's a rock star. No other way to say it, right? No other way to say it. He's a rock star in the state. He has an approval rating in the high 70s right now. And it's not like that's a blip either. Right? It's not like, well, you get in the high 70s coming off an election, or it was, you know, coming right off a diagnosis of cancer. No, these numbers have sustained. Right. He's been in the 60s and in the 70s for quite some time. We're talking years of polling that illustrate that the people of Maryland really like the job that Larry Hogan is doing. And again, this is a state where it's 2-1 Democrats to Republicans. So he's liked not only by Republicans, he's clearly liked by Democrats as well. And the question is why? Well, I mean, look, he's very measured at what he does. There's a lot of common sense in what he says. He's got foils on the Democratic Party, especially in the last election, where you had very liberal policies that people were pushing, and he would be the foil to that. So that kind of helps him. He's also a meat and potatoes kind of guy. He's not very flashy. Coming off the last governor, you know, who liked to, you know, flex his muscles, literally flex his muscles, and play a guitar, and who would love to be out in front of the cameras and wanted to run for president of the United States when he was governor of Maryland. The one thing about Larry Hogan that is different from a lot of other politicians, and I guess maybe even movements that we have seen in the last couple of years in this country, not just around Maryland, is that he was able to take the anti-establishment streak in this country. Right. Because remember, that was his whole thing. I'm not a politician. Change Maryland. We're going to do something different here. He was able to take that anti-establishment streak, that kind of populist streak that we have seen, again, not only in Maryland, not only in the country, but across the world, for that matter. He was able to take it and he was able to govern with it. That's the big difference. There are many of these movements where they wanted power, they got power, but really could never take that next step to govern with it. I think of the Tea Party to an extent. I think of Brexit, right? People vote for Brexit. Now they can't figure out how to do Brexit. I look at what's happening in the Democratic Party, this huge push to the left. If they get control, would they ever be able to do it? And are they really pushing away people, even though they're getting more powerful in their own parties? But that's the secret to Larry Hogan's success. It was the anti-establishment part of what Americans wanted, what Marylanders wanted. You know, we do need change. And he was able to actually govern with it. And there's an interesting press release that was put out by 28 Maryland state senators on the shutdown that we have right now. It was calling on President Trump to initiate compromise. And they go on to say, while it may sound simplistic, everyone doesn't always get everything they want. That's how compromise works. And that's what we are asking that you do to end the government shutdown with President Trump. Well, then I would say, you know what? That's a two-way street, isn't it? I mean, isn't compromise a two-way street? You have to give, and you expect the other party to give as well. And at the end of the day, you meet in the middle. Well, if that is the case, if really these 28 senators from Maryland want compromise, well, President Trump's asking for $5.6 billion for a fence. Now, it's not even really technically a wall. And I guess it all depends on what your definition of it is, but he's even willing to say it's a fence. So he wants $5.6 million. Democrats don't want any money for the wall or the fence, so they want zero. He wants 5.6. So what, in common sense terms, would be the compromise? $2.8 billion. Would anybody go for that on the Democratic Party? Would President Trump go for it? At this point, I think he might take it just to get the out-of-jail card to end this government shutdown. But we don't want to talk about that. But we have learned that, yes, people do want common sense. They want measured government. And we're getting that in Maryland. And maybe, even though Donald Trump doesn't like Larry Hogan, everyone in Washington could figure that out and get this government shutdown over with.